led many to believe the scale of disaster was far greater than Tokyo's authorities have ever admitted. Last year's devastating earthquake and tsunami not only killed thousands, but also knocked out the Fukushima nuclear plant, spilling uncontrolled amounts of radiation into the atmosphere, soil, and sea.
300 tons of contaminated water is leaking into the Pacific Ocean. All the predictions now say that a plume of radioactive water will be coming to North America next year.
Projections show most of the radioactive ocean plume from Fukushima will hit our coast, the U.S. West Coast, sometime later this year.
It's radioactive cesium 134, 137, strontium 90, now contributing to the contamination of the Pacific Ocean.
Radioactive findings may only be the tip of the iceberg.
Tensions in Japan are rising over the radioactive water leaking into the Pacific Ocean from the country's crippled Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant, which was devastated by the earthquakes and
radiation
tsunami of 2011.
To into our atmosphere.
Tuna caught
for
off the
centuries.
Californian coast contain radioactive isotopes brought over from the waters of Japan.
This is the first time such a large migrating fish has been shown to carry radioactivity so far.
They've actually found low levels of radiation in seafood off the coast of California. That raises a lot of alarm bells.
It's been 3 years since the Fukushima nuclear power plant disaster in Japan. This April, radiation from Japan is expected to arrive in the ocean waters off San Diego.
A scientist is now estimating that radiation from Japan's Fukushima nuclear disaster 3 years ago could now reach our west coast this April.
Radiation is coming across the Pacific in the ocean currents, contaminating all of the sea life.
Environmental officials in California say there's been another highly troubling report about what's going on in the Pacific. The scientists call it the sea star wasting syndrome. That's the technical name. But something is killing the starfish.